Today I have a fun, quick, and simple project for Valentine's Day and beyond. Perhaps bachelorette occasions could be useful. So it's kind of funny, boxer shorts. And it holds a sizable gift. It kind of flares out a little bit at the base, and it has a little crotch area there at the bottom. The back looks like the back of boxers, which makes me giggle, and the front's cute. The front's cute to put a little button on there on the front, and using some vertically striped paper for the waistband, I think makes it look more like a cute little waistband. So you could certainly get creative with whatever it is you would like to put inside your boxer shorts. I went ahead and put some Reese's Peanut Butter Cup hearts in here. Those are usually a crowd favorite. My husband likes those a lot. And this cute little chocolate lollipop, which I'll probably keep for myself. This is super easy to put together. However, I have everything cut out to put it together a second time to show you exactly how that works. The paper is really fun to pick out. I used this floral pattern, obviously. And I think kind of anything goes with that. I can't wait to see how you make yours. So let's do this. I have the main part of the boxers here. Then I have my waistband panels, which I think look nice in a striped paper, and then the main panels here. And I'm gonna do some inking around the edges of these shapes. This is optional, but I think it's a nice touch. I have several of these color pedal ink pads from Amazon. I think just anything that's remotely coordinating is gonna look nice, like a light pink, hot pink, a red. I think I'm gonna go with this pink here. It sort of just finishes off the edge and looks nice. It looks nice without doing this too, but I just like this effect. I can't help it. I do this with every project that has panels, especially when you can really see it, like on this. You can really see it, so it's nice. On the black, the mainly black panels, it's not gonna be as visible unless I have like a super black ink pad. So that I could probably skip inking on there. But on this, it just creates a nice effect, even if it's a little imperfectly applied. Next, I'm gonna take these two bottom pieces here, which are identical, and set them aside. Then I have the front and the back are also identical. I smudged my hand lotion on there, it's cute. So these are the same, but the panels make them different. And then the side panels are also the same. And it's easy to tell which of these goes on the sides because they look like this. So these are going to have an even border around the bottom. Both of them are going to get glued on like this. And then they both have a waistband piece that looks like this. Okay, so these are identical. They're a little wider at the bottom because of the shape of this. So these will be going here and here, like this. Then I have the remaining waistband pieces, which are one long one to go on the back, and then two others that are gonna go like this. The end is sticking out here, and then the side is straight up and down. So these go like this, and this is gonna go right in between them. This will go on the front. So I will grab one of these two. These are identical. These are going to be going like this.
All right, I love you guys.
So we have the sides there. I have the front here. I'll grab this. This goes on the back. It's kind of hard to see this fold line up at the top, but this will be going just underneath it with an even border around the sides and the top. And since that's the back, I'll put these panels on. So that's how the back is gonna look. It's got those butt seams like boxers have. And then this is the front, just like that. And then it's cute with a button in the middle there. So I'm gonna go ahead and glue all these in place. Easy peasy. So I'll glue these two sides together, the panels on them. So if you've been watching my videos for some time, or if you've watched many of them, you might know that I have always only used Scotch quick dry tacky glue, quick dry adhesive, Scotch tacky glue. It has a couple different names, but it's the same thing. For a brief period, I did use some green glue that's like super eco-friendly and very non-toxic. But today I'm using this art glitter glue, which a lot of you guys have said that you like. And I just really like this precision tip here, especially for on camera, because I feel like you can see what I'm doing better in this video with more of a precision tip on the nozzle. I saw someone using it on Instagram. A couple people, I believe, I saw using it on Instagram, and I noticed how easily you could see what they were doing because of the precision tip. And for gluing really tiny pieces, this is gonna come in handy. I'm kind of shocked that I haven't tried this yet. I think I was a little intimidated, not only by trying something new, I guess, but also because it's not as easy to find. Sometimes I need to restock my glue at a moment's notice. And the Scotch glue, which I still like, it's just very easy to find wherever craft supplies are sold. Maybe the art glitter glue can be too, I'm not sure. But then someone else had said, a few people had said something about storing it with a pin in it and like a special tip and stuff. And then I got a little nervous about not knowing exactly what's up with that. I think mine did come with this. Mine came with a pin and a metal tip. And I'm not sure why you would need to use that instead of this. I haven't like informed myself yet, but this is pretty great. I believe I got it on Amazon a very long time ago. I think maybe even my crafting friend Bridget Mann might have even sent me some art glitter glue at some point. Thank you, Bridget. I'm using it now. There's the sides. Okay, here comes the back side. So let me know in the comments what kind of glue you like, how you feel about things like that in general, like when you get stuck on a product. Is it easy for you to embrace another similar product and try something? Or do you like to just stick with what you know once you found something that you like? I think perhaps I like to stick with what I know. I guess I'm discovering that about myself, seeing as how I haven't tried this lovely glue that I've had in my glue stash for like 10 years, probably. Maybe not that long, but could be. It could be. You know, the older you get, the more the time flies, and you think, oh, I just got that. And then you're like, no, I got that 10 years ago. But it's okay. It happens. I guess I could just put this nozzle on and see what happens. There's probably not a wrong way to do that. We could find out. Funny. Okay. Another glue that seems to be really popular is the Barely Arts glue, which I just received from Amazon that I ordered. So tell me what you like to use for glue. Okay, so I put this on here. You just kind of firmly do that and then twist it a little bit, and it's really on. And then it's a much more precision tip. So, and then you can temporarily store it like this. It says right on the bottle, it tells you about it. So, mystery solved. I think I will save that for when I'm using glue on a much more intricate, small piece. But these pieces for the boxer shorts are pretty big, so I'm gonna save this for later. So next I'll glue the backside panels in place. Easy peasy. So there's that. I'm gonna put a button on the front next. So I'm gonna find a cute button for the front there. And I have a big old button collection. That's kind of fun to see. I have to keep my daughter kind of out of this one because she has been commandeering all my other embellishments, which is, it's fine. It's cute that she's so excited about it. But this one, I'm like, let's not mix up the colors that I have. So I guess you could put two. Two would be cute. But I'm going to use a Permatec Mini Adhesive Square from Glue Arts. And just put that right in the middle. Next, I'm going to glue these four together side to side. The sides are the same, doesn't matter which one you grab first. So next I'm going to close it up here. And I'm thinking maybe going forward for large gluing areas, I might still go back to the Scotch glue and then use the art glitter glue for more of the precision areas or small pieces as just like a loosely general way of doing things. I don't recall what the price per ounce comparison is, but I bet Art Glitter Glue is probably more of a small company. It says Arizona. Might be nice to support them. There's a choice. I'm sure the people at Scotch are quite lovely as well. So let me know in the comments if that's a factor for you when you're shopping. Made in the USA. If you live in the USA or made in your country. Small business versus big business. Okay, oops. Now I'm gonna fold over these top flaps. And those are there just for reinforcement to make the top nice and straight and sturdy. Now we just need to put the bottom on, which is two identical pieces that are gonna go one on the outside, one on the inside. So I feel like it's probably easier to start by putting one on the inside. So essentially it'll be going like this, one on the inside, one on the outside. It doesn't matter which one, because they're identical. So, might be a good time to get some scrap paper out, because I might be getting some glue on your work surface. So I will start by anchoring one side. I guess I'll anchor the other side. There's not a super right or wrong way to do this. Just whatever is easy for you. So you'll have to let me know how you make yours, what kind of paper you use, if you're doing it for Valentine's or some other cute little saucy, intimate sort of theme, like bachelorette party maybe, girl's birthday, like being funny kind of, or I don't know. You'll have to share if you want all about it. These would look cool if they were kind of satiny looking, like the Mary Lava cardstock from, I've gotten it from 12x12 cardstock.shop, and it looks kind of like taffeta. It's like holographic, super shiny, some kind of paper that looks like satin, like really shiny. That could be fun. I suppose even that kind of sounds almost like a boxer shorts, like the sport. So you could really get creative with your paper choices for this. I'm starting to envision some super cool boxers that you guys are going to be making. I can't wait to see. So now I am just putting the bottom in place. Nice and easy because it's already being held in the right shape by the last steps that we did. So I just want to make sure it dries nicely. And we are all done, except for putting some tissue paper, shredded paper inside, either one perhaps would be nice, and then some kind of gift. I got this tissue paper from Michael's this year in 2024. It's really cute. I also have some nice shredded paper that I got from them. I don't really feel like getting this out because it has this like plastic gold in it, and I feel like my cat is going to come running and eat it. But I think you get the idea. I had a big package of Reese's Hearts in here, but I ate it. And my daughter helped, and so did my husband. And this big chocolate heart. So, very cute. I can't wait to see how you do yours. So there you have it. Boxer shorts gift bag. Woo, a little racy. Fun and flirty or dirty laundry. You decide. Let me know what you think in the comments and share a picture of yours with us on social media like Facebook, Instagram, yada yada. I always love to see, and so do the rest of our crafty friends. So thanks for watching. Happy Valentine's Day. Happy crafting. Catch you next time. It's underwear.